I have worked on several GPS tracker projects using NodeMCU, SIM800L module and more. However, today I have something exciting to share with you. Introducing an Arduino Uno shield specifically designed for GPS trackers and IoT devices. This shield is equipped with built-in GPS and 4G SIM support, making it very useful. To demonstrate the capabilities of this Arduino GPS and LTE shield, I have created a compact GPS tracker project using Arduino. Now let's dive into the unboxing of the SIM7000C Arduino Uno shield, proudly manufactured by DF Robot. Special thanks to DF Robot for sending me this product. For more information and to purchase the shield, please check the product link provided in the video description. This shield supports selected quad-band FDD LTE bands, GPRS, and especially NB-Iot SIMs. You can control it using AT commands similar to other SIMCOM modules. Additionally, it supports a wide range of navigation satellite systems. You have the option to use either an NB-Iot SIM card or a regular LTE supported SIM card or GSM SIM card. However, it's important to check compatibility before making a purchase. The SIM7000 shield is available in three different types: 7000A, E, and C. You should choose the one that aligns with the LTE band supported by your SIM card service provider. For my country, I have chosen the 7000C variant. I am currently inserting it into an Arduino Uno board, but you can also use an Arduino Mega. Let's take a closer look at the shield. The shield features the SIMCOM SIM7000C chip. There is a reset button connected to the Arduino reset pin. All Arduino input and output pins are available for connecting sensors. It has I2C pins and UART pins. A boot button is provided to turn on the SIM7000 chip. You can also turn it on using a command line in software or by pulling up Arduino pin 12. The boot button is connected to the Arduino pin 12 as well. The SIM card slot is designed for a regular size SIM card. If you want to use a micro or nano SIM card, you will need to use a SIM adapter. Normally, the Arduino USB serial is connected to pin 0 and 1. However, the DF Robot SIM7000 Arduino library uses pins 7 and 8 for software serial communication. So, in this case, I have selected this switch pin 7 and 8 side. This module is particularly useful for GPS trackers or GPS related projects as it supports a wide range of navigation systems. Next, I will be installing the GPS antenna and the GSM network antenna, which are included with the module. A micro USB port is used for firmware updates of the SIM7000 chip. The shield features two LEDs for power and load, as well as a network indication LED. In the product description, it mentioned an onboard BME280 environmental sensor for temperature, humidity, etc. However, I could not find the BME280 sensor on the board. Later, I discovered on the product wiki page that this sensor is not available in the version 2.0 or above. Therefore, there is no onboard environmental sensor. Nevertheless, you can connect any sensor using Arduino pins. I am using a regular LTE supported SIM card, not NB-Iot SIM card, using a SIM adapter. To power the module, I am using two lithium batteries in series providing 7.4 volts. Alternatively, you can use 7 volt to 12 volt. Keep in mind, the SIM module consumes a significant amount of current when registering to the network. Hence, I am using an additional power source on the DC socket. To get started with Arduino IDE, I have installed two libraries, the DF Robot General SIM Library and the NB-Iot SIM 7000 Shield Library. Here are some sample codes in the library for testing, connecting MQTT server, GPS test, HTTP, etc. I have also prepared a small test code. It includes a push button connected to Arduino Digital Pin 3. When pressed, it will send an SMS with a Google Map link showing the device location. It may take a few seconds, and there we go. The location is displayed. This can be used as an SOS button or a safety device. Although this code requires future improvements, it was just for testing and demonstration purpose. Although this project was not web server based, I hope to work on various IoT based projects and GPS trackers in the future using this shield. Thank you for watching and see you soon.